At least Nick Foles has some track record. He has a great season in which he went for like 27 and touchdowns and two interceptions. And two.
Yeah,
then
one.
He just won three postseason games. He just won them in backup capacity when it's hard to just walk out there and replace a guy many people thought would have been MVP of the league. So Foles, yes, I would pay that much for Foles.
So let's review this for a second. Let's review what you have to give up. A number one, which is what, if you want a quarterback, you have to go high
anyway.
Number one
right.
to get one of the four top-rated quarterbacks. Most people think they'll be gone by number 10.
I'd much rather have Foles than any of
and
those
then
kids.
You, right, and then because Foles is proven to some degree. And then you have to give up a number four.
Well, that could be a starter in the league.
Okay,
it could be.
Down the road, but you can get that back. You can get that back in time. In the two most important games of Nick Foles' life, here's what he did. The NFC Championship and the Super Bowl. You think those are big games?
That's great.
Here's what he did. 54 of 76 for 725 yards, six touchdowns, one interception. He didn't manage the game. He won the game.
Yeah, he did.
So when you say it's a small sample size, I'm saying to you, he's more attractive.
Well, it's a bigger sample size than those college kids.
The people who don't get Kirk Cousins should go and do this for Nick Foles.
Tony, first of all, I look at the names being thrown around. I know that the USC and UCLA quarterbacks are chief among them, and I watched them like for two or three years, and I don't understand the hullabaloo. If Foles is available to me for a first, and I can sell the other team on a fourth, maybe we haggle, get it down to a fifth.
Garoppolo,
I'm going after Nick
Garoppolo
Foles.
Garoppolo went for a second. I think
he had no record.
I think Foles should draw more.
Yes.
He won the Super Bowl.
Yeah, absolutely. Listen to you. You're excited about Nick Foles.
Yeah.